Good morning, students. As per our syllabus, CS8391, data structure, third semester BECSE for 2017 regulation. The third unit title is nonlinear data structures. Especially, we are going to deal with a data structure called tree. I hope you remember that in the first unit, we studied a data structure. And that data structure is one which deals with linear data structure as well as a very primitive data structure, that is linked list. Strictly speaking, it is called as a list, but it is implemented by a array as well as a pointer. The pointer implementation is widely called by the name linked list, right? The second unit, we have seen two more linear data structure, that is a stack and a queue. Under the queue, we have seen several special kinds of queue also. So the first two units is completely dedicated to linear data structure. In that, first unit deals with the list, second unit deals with stack and queue. Now, the third unit we are going to see today is the one which deals with the topic tree data structure. So in tree data structure, what you can give a definition is, it is a nonlinear data structure. Yes, of course. And if you could see that, it contains some collection of nodes. It should contain some collection of nodes. What is nodes? This diagram, the circle are called as nodes. And the line connecting the circle are called edges, right? And what kind of relationship this kind of data structure is useful? It is useful to represent a hierarchical relationship. What do you mean by hierarchical relationship? See, in a family, you have father and son and grandchildren, right? So that is to be treated as a hierarchy. Likewise, in an office, you have a head, below that assistant, below that sub-assistant, like that, right? So it may have the hierarchy. Likewise, this tree data structure organizes the data in a hierarchical manner. So one data that is treated as the supreme data, and that is stored on the top. And that data is called by the name root. See, among the list of items A, B, C, D, E, F, G, like Sweta told about a list of grocery items, Jansi told about project team members, Vincent told about a to-do list. So these are all the data items. In the data items, the first data item, which is treated as the most important one or key one, maybe put it in the top priority or top level, and it is treated as the root node. And all other nodes are treated as the sub nodes, that is arising from, you may not say that arising from, but it is having a certain connection or a certain link between the top, that is a root node, and their and its value. So that is the hierarchical relationship it is showing, right? So when you come to this tree data structure, you come across several new terminologies like root node, parent node, child node, leaf node, degree, level, height, depth. Students, you should remember all these terms, and you should be able to define all these terms either by a simple English or by a mathematical statement. Of course, your ebook as well as many textbooks will deal with the definition. I am not going to give that definition in the slide. However, I will define the terms through the presentation. So what is meant by a root node? In a given tree, the node that is at the top, which gives rise to many other node as their descendants, is going to be a root node. For example, in the given tree, what is the root node? A is the root node. What is a parent node? A node which gives rise to children. It may be at the top level, that means at the top of the tree, or it may be at the intermediate level, but definitely not at the lowest level, because lowest level is the node which doesn't give any children, right? So here, what are the parents? A is the parent for B and C, B is the parent for D and E, C is the parent for F and G, like that you can say, right? Next, what is the definition of a child node? The node that is at the last level. Sorry, the node that doesn't give rise to any child node. or that doesn't have any children. So what are the child nodes here? H, I, J, K, L, M. So H, I, J, K, L, they are not in the last level. M is in the last level. But what is the similarity between these H, I, J, K, L, M? It gives rise to some nodes. If doesn't give rise to some nodes, then it is a child. When you take D, see here E is also a child node because it doesn't give any children. So that is the child node. So that is also hold food for leaf node. Particularly, leaf node is the one which doesn't, which is at the last level and doesn't give any children. Degree. What do you mean by degree? The number of links arising out of a node. In general, for a tree, the degree is n. N can be of any value. N can be of any value. N is the degree. N may be 4, N may be 10, N may be 100, like that. So what is that? There is one node should be there as a root node, and from that node you have many branches. So that is the each and every branch is counted as a degree. So how is the degree? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the degree is 6 for this tree. In addition to that, there are some restrictions in the degree. Say for example, if the degree value n equal to 2, then what it means? Every time the tree has 2 branch. So if you form a node, here also you have 2 branch. If you form a node, here also you have a 2. So a tree that has a degree n equal to 2 is called as a binary tree. So the tree given here is the best example for a binary tree. Next level. When you go to define the level, you have to say that the root node is at the level 0. That is the layered view. The layered view of the tree data structure is called level. So what is the layered view? This is at level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, and level 4. So layered. This A is at level 0 because it is a root node. B and C is at level 1. So if you ask how many levels are there, you should say 5. You have 5 levels. There are 5 levels are there. And if you say the number of the level, so root node at level 0, like an array, right? So if you define an array size as 10, the maximum index number is 9, right? Because it starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, 0 is also counted. If you count 0, then 0 to 9 will counts up to 10. So that is the, that's a similar case is hold good for level here. So level is the one which views the tree data structure as a layered architecture. In that, the root node alone is situated at the top level and it is assigned a level number 0. Accordingly, the other level numbers are represented. When you ask a question about the maximum level is the number of levels. How many number of levels are there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 levels. So what is that? There are 5 levels. So it comes up to 4 starting from 0 and there are 5 levels. So what is height? So whenever you look a taller thing, so how you look at it? You look at the face position like this, right? So you are looking at the taller tower, you are looking at the taller mountain, you are looking at the taller person, you are looking at the taller objects like this, right? So the height of a tree is treated as a count from leaf node to root node. Leaf node to root node. So the leaf node is at height 1, root node is height as a second, 3, 4, 5. Like that you can say the height, right? So what is the maximum height of the tree? 5. Root node is at the height A. Node F is at height, 3. Node L is at height, 2. Like that. Now come to another parameter, depth. So whenever you want to see the depth, Say, for example, when you are at the top of the mountain, you want to view the downside, or when you are at the going to see the well and you are going to see how deep the well is, how deep the well is, or when you are standing in the top of the building and you want to see the bottom side, you always make your head downside like this, right, to look the depth. So likewise, when you want to define the depth is treated from root node to leaf node. That is, the root node is at the depth 1, and next level node 2, 3, 4, 5. So the maximum depth is 5, but root node is at the depth 1, next level node is at depth 2. So you, please students, you do not get confused these three parameters. So the maximum level of the given tree is 5, the maximum height of the tree is 5, maximum depth of the tree is 5, that given tree. But the level for root node, the level starts at 0. For depth, the root node depth is 1. For height, the root node height is 5, because it starts from bottom to bottom up. So when you are going for height, it is from bottom to top. So when you go for it, is top to down. So that is the way you have to define the tree terminologies, right? So next comes the representation. So what is this representation is the deal about? See, this is a diagrammatic representation. See, whatever in the diagram, this is a diagrammatic representation. So A is one item, B is another item, and C is another item. So that items are represented in the memory like this. In the memory like this, it is represented. Not in the memory, but logically you are representing the tree. Because in order to represent the hierarchy relationship, you are representing the tree data structure as a collection of nodes and edges, where the node is the one which holds the data, edge is the one which gives the connection between the data. Say, for example, if Sweta is saying that he is having a list of grocery items, for her, the rice holds the top position, followed by dal, followed by any cereals, and followed by any sugar, like that it comes down, right? So this is the logical representation of the tree data structure. But how the data is stored in the computer memory, for which you need some kind of calculation in order to estimate the memory. So how to estimate the memory? There are two ways. I already told that. Whenever you go to represent the tree, represent any data structure in the computer, you have two ways. One is by means of array, another by means of linked list. So in case of array, that is represented as a linear representation. In case of pointer, that is represented as a linked representation. So there are two kinds of array. One is linear representation, another one is linked representation. Coming to linear representation. In linear representation, first of all, since it is the concept of storing the data items in the memory, first of all, you should compute the array size. So this is the given array, given tree, and you have to represent the given tree in the array, for which the formula for computing the array size is 2 to the power L plus 1 minus 1. So what is L here? L is the maximum level. So what is the level? 1. 2, 3, 4, right? So what is the maximum level? So maximum level is 4. So 2 to the power 4 plus 1. What is it? 2 to the power 5. So 2 to the power 5 means 32 minus 1. So 31. So the memory location is 1, 2, 4, 5, except 31 memory location is required for representing the tree, right? If you take that level as the maximum count, see here, I forgot to say one thing. It is not the maximum count of the level, maximum count, that is total number of level. It's not the maximum total count of the level. Total count of the level is 1, 2, 3, 4 levels, right? But it is the maximum number of the level. Maximum number is, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So the maximum level is 3. So 2 to the power 4, 3 plus 1, that is 2 to the power 4. 2 to the 4 is 16, 16 minus 1, 15. So you don't confuse with the maximum level and maximum count. Here itself I got a confusion, right? So you don't confuse with the maximum count is the number that is allotted for the level. So that is 3, maximum level. Maximum count, so 1, 2, 3, so there is a count. It is not maximum count, it is a count. It is, what is the count of the level in the tree? That is the count like that. So after estimating the memory size like this, so no 31 location is required, only 15 location is required there. That is started from 1 to 15 or 0 to 15 like that, 0 to 14 like that. So what is that? So given node n should be stored. When you take the node, first root node you should take, because in a tree you should read from the root node. So the first node you should take is the A. So the root node A should be stored in the location 2n. So first of all, you store the root node in the first location. So just to start the root node in the first location. Since A is stored in the first location, that n equal to 1, its left side C should be stored in C, left side should be 2n. So 2 into 1, then it is 2. Right child B should stored in the location 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 3. Like that, you go for a process. What is the M? Since the C is stored in location 2, the location for M is 2 into 2 will give rise to 4. So M is stored in location 4. Likewise for S, what is S? 2 into 2 plus 1, that is fifth location. So likewise you should count. So this is what the linear representation is conducted. For storing the tree elements or tree data items into the computer memory. Coming to linked representation. So linked representation is the pointer representation. So every node, then logically it is each node is represented as a circle, but with the node you have to represent as a rectangular box like this with the three partition. This partition is for left pointer, this partition is for right pointer, and in the mid you have the data item. So likewise, you have to complete the tree. If there is a node descended from the left side, that address is not null. Otherwise, the address is made null. See, L is a null node, J right pointer is null, G both the left pointer and right pointer is null, E the right pointer is null. So like that, the right pointer is null. So here also, you have to assume, because in prior you should not know the address. Just you assume that you have stored the data A. And the A left pointer is 2 and its right pointer is 6. That means in the second address, you should store B. And in the sixth address, you should store C. Now you assume B. For B, you have D and E. So B and D. So B 3, 4. So this is the address you have mentioned on your own. So no need of the calculation, because you do not know what is the address field is this. You're using the ampersand symbol or the 13 through program only we can get. But now I am saying that. So left point address is 2 means the B should store in the second location. Right point address is 6 means C should store in the sixth location. Likewise, for C, the left pointer is 7 and right pointer is 8. So that means the left pointer item G should store in the seventh location. The right pointer address is H should store in the 8th location. So likewise, you should represent the linked representation. What is the advantage? So in general, the advantages between the linear as well as linked representation is the difference between the array and pointer. So in linear representation, or otherwise called as sequential representation, the memory is static allocation. In the linked list, the memory allocation is dynamic memory allocation, right? So as usual, when you represent the data in an array, it is very simpler to implement and easier to locate any node by mentioning the index. But what is the disadvantage? When you talk about disadvantage, so as I said, in the array implementation of a list, there are considerable data movement. because the array is fixed, array is fixed. If you want to either increase the data or decrease the data, you have to either, so you got, if you want to insert the data or delete the data, you have to either increase the memory size by moving all the data. If you delete also, you have to move all the data in order to maintain the memory as compact as possible. However, you may feel loss of wastage of memory. Say for example, here in this case, only you have how many nodes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only 8 nodes are there. That is only 8 data items are there. For which, how many memory location I have declared? I have initialized 15 memory location. That is 1, 2. That is half of the memory location remain unutilized. So that is the wastage of memory. That is a very big disadvantage with respect to array. That is a static representation. When you come for linked representation of tree, so you do not know about the depth. So you know, no need to call the depth, and you cannot confuse with what is maximum level, what is the count, whether I have to put 3 or 4, let's say that kind of count. So it is a dynamic memory allocation. So because why you need to call the depth? So the depth value L is used for estimate the memory, but that thing is not here. Also here, no data movement, only the pointer adjustment is there. See, pointer adjustment is there in linked. There also in linked list, you do not move any data, but just you move the pointer. So you move the pointer from one place to another. So that means the insertion and deletion operation has been accessed. So what is the disadvantage? You cannot access the node directly. You have to go from one location, one point to that particular point. And also it requires some additional memory. Why it needs additional memory? Because it needs left address as well as right address, right? So left pointer address is also required, right pointer address is also required in order to access the value. And when you take the case of leaf node, this is a wastage of memory. There are too much of null pointers, right? So that too much of null pointers will also lead to. So when compared with the wastage of memory of unused location as well as the null pointers, both the linear as well as linked representation has the same drawback. But the thing is, it is dynamic as well as that is static. So each has its pros and cons, and it is up to you to decide whether you go for linear representation or you go for linked representation. So there are variety of tree data structures we are going to see. One is binary tree, expression tree, binary search tree, AVL tree, then MVS tree, B tree, split tree. Out of that, our syllabus comprises of these trees: binary, expression, binary search, AVL, B tree. B tree as well as B plus tree is there. So we are going to deal these kind of trees, and the binary tree, expression tree, binary search tree, AVL tree are the tree that deals with internal memory like ROM and RAM. So you know that, right? In a computer you have a ROM and RAM, read-only memory, random. So in that memory, if you want to store any data item, then you should follow this kind of data structure, the tree data structure. But if you take the case of external memory, what is external memory? Your hard disk, your pen drive, previously you have a CD, floppy drive, those are all magnetic tapes, those are all external memory. There, if you want to store any data, that then the data tree data structure that is helpful is MVA, B trees, play, red, black, B plus, there are plenty of trees are available. So as far as our syllabus is concerned, we are going to deal with binary, expression, binary search, AVL, and B tree as well as B plus tree, right? So with this, I stop this session. I will stop the recording also, and we will resume back in another 5 minutes.
Okay, sir.